Backstage at Auckland's Vector Arena. Look who it is.
It's morbidly obese. Ate too much barbecue. Feels a little bit full. It was Sheeran.
It wasn't the barbecue that did it. There was a pudding. It was a mango coconut meringue.
Oh.
And I had three helpings of that.
But see, meringue, much like a pancake, it's you eat and you're full, but then 20 minutes later you're hungry.
I don't know. I find it was the silent killer because I feel like it's expanding.
Oh, it's expanding.
And that's what's doing that.
I think it's okay when Ed says he's got a food baby. I don't think it's okay when you say he's fully pregnant.
Right.
Yeah.
Your face is cleared up.
Thanks. Yeah, thank you. I had a Tahitian glow for a little bit.
Did it last a while?
It lasted probably two days.
Oh, wow.
I looked like I'd been on holiday. Thank
you
for
that. She looks like she'd been on holiday and fallen face first into a plate of Marmite, which just happened to happen when she was on holiday.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
That's okay.
Thank you for coming to the venue as well. I know it's sometimes a ball ache to come to the venues, but yeah.
No, well, it won't be happening again, Ed, so make the most of it. What's your first question? Oh, we're interviewing you. You shouldn't have apologised or said thank you for coming to the venue.
Now, you landed and tweeted about chocolate. How much chocolate have you received as a gift since that
Fair
tweet?
Amount. I just got some really fancy chocolate as well from a chocolatier place.
And have you changed your mind on New Zealand chocolate?
Oh, yeah, of course. There's obviously good chocolate in New Zealand. It's just the first chocolate I ate was shocking. So I wanted to ask them to step their
game up. What was it?
It was the one you get on a pillow.
Oh, that's what we did say. Classic. Maybe you got a wee chucky on the pillow.
That would have been a cheap one.
It'll be a hotel cheap buy.
Yeah.
Classic. Okay.
Were you surprised at how passionate New Zealanders were about chocolate? Because you kind of were like, well, he's come all this way, but he has insulted our chocolate, so we'll
I don't think chocolate's your thing. I think coffee is your thing. I think, like, the best coffee in the world probably comes from here. And what else? Your meat's really good. Your seafood's really good. Your movies are really good.
Girls.
You can let chocolate go. You can let chocolate go.
We want chocolate.
Girls. And the girls.
And the girls.
Yeah. Oh, stop it.
I don't know. I've never.
You've never had a kiwi?
No.
I thought you were going to say I've never looked at girls in New Zealand like that. I was like, oh yeah, sweet.
No. I love the accent.
Okay. Good.
Love the accent.
Good.
So it's a possibility.
Yeah. But do you just say that, or do you really like the accent?
I really like the accent.
Really? Does it make it sound a bit dumb?
No.
Does it really make us sound dumb?
Yeah, because we're like dumb. Does it make us sound dumb? Like, it's okay if it makes us sound dumb. What does it make us sound?
Dumb.
You know, like, yeah. It does. It makes us sound a little bit dumb. That's
or sexy.
Okay.
Could have gone with sexy.
That's a little more dumb. Because last time we talked, we made an agreement that when you sold 10 million albums, you could start being an arsehole. How close are you to 10 million albums?
I've done 12 now.
Why are you still being nice to everybody?
Because I want to sell 20.
And then you're going to be, at any stage, you're just going to be like, you know what, I've done it now. You
no,
wake up early, you do media everywhere you go, you sell out concerts, you still talk
well, this
to
is the way. This is the way I view it. I do everything I can to make sure that the one time I come to you with a song that maybe isn't going to be successful, you give it the benefit of the doubt and play it, because I know for a fact there are people that are on your playlist that as soon as that song doesn't work, they're gone, because they don't do anything for you. They do it in America, they're just like, oh, that song's not working. And if the song wasn't working, I'd like to think that you had enough good faith in me to push it to a point where it would work. Whereas there are lots of artists who I'm guessing have never even come on your station that you're just like, am
and
I right?
Some of them are really mean, Ed. You know, like,
do you take the stuff off when...
Well, no, it's not my job, but...
Do you?
Yeah, some of them are very mean.
Yeah.
The boss does it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Well, there we go. So even if I start making shit music, you'll still play it, which is positive.
Can you please release the shittest song? Just make a... On purpose, make an awful song. I don't know if it's in you.
It's a matter of opinion, isn't it?
Yeah, I know it is, but...
My shit song might be someone's favourite song.
Yeah, and then it might be, like, you might do that thing where you write a shit song on purpose, but it's one of those songs that becomes part of, like that Crazy Frog thing a few years back.
Tell me, who's come on your show and been a bit of a douche?
If we tell you that, will you tell us who's been a douche to you, like a big celebrity? Have you ever had one of those?
People are genuinely... quite nice to me, but
okay.
It's the way that they treat the people around me, and I do see a lot of that where everyone's really friendly to me, and then they'll kind of treat my team like.
And you find out about it.
I see it.
Yeah. Oh yeah, right.
I'm like, what? Yeah. What are you doing that for? Yeah. So,
well, you might be friends with him, but Dizzy Rascal wanted to knife me once.
Wow, why?
Well, because
Fletch said to him,
I deserved it.
Well, because he's been stabbed. Did you know that? He's been stabbed.
Yeah. Eight
like
times.
8 times. And I said, would you rather be stabbed 8 times individually over the course of, say,
a few years,
or 8 times at once?
And he said,
how about I stab you 8 times and we'll find out?
And it was the interview went, over.
Crash. And then the big people behind him took a step closer to him. And I thought it was throw down, but.
Well, I think there are things you can joke about and things that have probably been quite traumatic in people's lives.
Yeah. Like, that was one.
Stabbing's probably not one of them.
Yeah. Do you know when you stop doing this music thing, you could totally be like a mediator. You've got a real mediator feel to you. Or host like a chat show.
Yeah.
Like a classier Jeremy Kyle. You've got quite a calming influence. You know, not like mangled teeth and I've impregnated my sister.
Just come on. Let's just all be friends. I don't know if it works. It works because Jeremy Kyle goes, you disgust me. You know, I think that. But I don't think that's the thing to say to Dizzy Rascal.
Well, I've learned my lesson.
You could have probably said a lot of other things that he probably would have found funny that could have been in bad taste as well. But yeah, it's so what, did he just stop the interview just then and there?
Yeah.
Got pretty quiet pretty quick. Pretty quiet.
I can imagine.
Pretty quick.
Just left.
So who then, to return the favour, who has been rude to your people? Anybody?
But not in the music world. Not in the music people are generally, if you get up to a certain point as a musician, you're kind of a nice person and that's why you're there. Like, all the biggest musicians in the world seem to be the nicest.
Who's the nicest then at the other end? Because you obviously don't want to drag anybody down, but what about pushing them up? Who's the nicest?
I mean, you know Taylor's pretty cool. She has a very good reputation of being lovely. The nicest, biggest person I've met was probably Paul McCartney. And he's someone who goes out of his way to come and speak to you and check how you are. Actually, Robbie Williams did that. Robbie Williams is big here, right?
Yeah.
I went to
a Robbie Williams concert. Got punched in the back of the head by an older woman.
Wow.
You don't push forward at a Robbie Williams concert. You're right at the front, apparently.
I didn't think it was the sort of concert you get punched in the head, but that's quite, that's quite cool.
We learned two things.
So I'd never met him before, and I was doing a German TV award show that he was at. And I was just in my dressing room on my own, just kind of like, and he just bowled in, sat down, chatted to me for about 2 hours. really intense chatting though. Like, are you okay? Are you on, like, are you doing any drugs? How's the stress level? How is it with like relationships and stuff? Like, really went in to check I was all right. So I thought that was quite cool.
Wow, that's because he's been there? Because he has lows?
And how? He's definitely had some moments.
He could be your co-host. On your chat show.
I reckon that it could be a cheeky chappy.
Yeah, you could bookend them and sit them in the middle.
I just think, there'd be a lot of innuendos and a lot of uses of the C word.
Really?
Yeah. You use that as a term of endearment here. I quite like it.
Yeah, you do.
I got called a sick today.
Did you?
Yeah.
A sick
sick.
Like, good is, like, that's good, but sick. Yeah. It's like.
Who said it?
Who said it?
Another station that we won't mention on this one.
Right. Well, like, you're a sick.
Sick.
Right, okay.
Yeah, funny.
Funny. Yeah, good.
Please, okay, yeah.
In fact, it's almost like the worst word that you put in front of it that takes the sting out of it.
Well, it's kind of a term of endearment among men in England. It's just not among women, so I'm sorry.
Yeah. Americans, they really get shocked when you say it.
Oh, man.
They.
I made that mistake a couple of times. I got talking to.
Who gave you talking to? We were like,
yeah, I said it in front of
Beyonce.
No, it was just a woman who happened to be there, and I've kind of changed my. I don't use it as much now. I used to use it all the time. You're not going to be able to put this on anyway, so it's.
We've got beepers.
We'll put a special bleep in.
Yeah. Do you like Vaughn said, you've got a very like calming demeanor. You're a very nice guy. Do you growl anyone? So like friends, if they've got a new boyfriend, you know where I'm heading with this. Calvin Harris, would you growl him?
No, he's cool.
Is he?
He's a really nice guy, yeah. Really, really nice guy.
So you give it the seal of approval with Taylor?
Yeah. Well, I'd give the seal of approval with... There are certain people that are just nice people in the industry. I met him probably like a year ago. Maybe a year and a half. Yeah, good guy. Really, really good guy.
How did he get so hot?
I think people blossom. So I'm still waiting.
Me too.
Yeah,
me too. You got your milk yet?
My what?
Your man.
What's my man?
It's when you're sick. It's like second puberty. You get a second growth. Wow. I'm told.
I hope so. It's substantially bigger than when I was 12.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, no, that's initial puberty. And then apparently like late 20s. So how old are you now?
Late 24.
24.
So I'm going to get...
You're still...
It's going to get bigger.
Yeah.
Is this happening?
Because...
I'm excited.
I was like, it's not happening. And then they say it happens when you become a dad. So I did that twice. And still pretty... It's nothing to write home
so
about.
So it's not a two-hander.
Not two of my hands. I do have quite large hands. I don't know. Like, that would all be relative to hand size.
Start dating really small women and feeling great about yourself.
Well, my wife is half Asian. I've not thought about it, but...
She really small?
All right.
Is she very small?
No, like she's not. She's got very, very large hands. Genetic throwback to a Caucasian size. Oh, almost Norwegian sized hands.
So is it more of a half a palm thing?
Do you know what I'm thinking? My penis might not be that small. It's her hands that are the real big things.
All right, Ed. Ed, we've got a green screen here in the room. We're going to come back next. We're going to change the camera setup here, the mic setup. And we're going to get you in front of the green screen with a little challenge.
A little game we're
to
called...
To get my mandic up.
If you like.
Well, the green screen's there, so if we need to make adjustments, I guess that's what you use.
We'll put
a green
sock over it, and then it can be any size you want.
what do you think?
Probably not sock length. That's a bit long. That's a bit grotesque. It's the challenge is called Malt Ed Talented.
Malt Ed Talented.
Let's get your name in it. In case you didn't realise.
But it doesn't actually, you know, it could have been anything.
Could be.
Yeah. It could have been multi-talent Ed.
That's what it was. I balls that up. Yeah, the Ed was at the end. Multi-talent Ed. Yes. Yeah. That's what it was.
That makes a lot more sense.
Thanks for making that better.
It's all right.
All right, we're back next with backstage at Auckland's Vector Arena. Look who it is.
It's morbidly obese. Ate too much barbecue. Feels a little bit full. It was Sheeran.
It wasn't the barbecue that did it. There was a pudding. It was a mango coconut meringue.
Oh.
And I had three helpings of that.
But see, meringue, much like a pancake, it's you eat and you're full, but then 20 minutes later you're hungry.
I don't know. I find it was the silent killer because I feel like it's expanding.
Oh, it's expanding.
And that's what it's doing.
I think it's okay when Ed says he's got a food baby. I don't think it's okay when you say he's